Let's have a bit of a play with MATLAB and Octave and the discrete Fourier transform. So let's just play with a really short sequence. So for example, something like that, 5, 7, 2, 9, 3, 6. So in terms of MATLAB index, that's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So remember, MATLAB starts at 1. So what do we expect? So we expect that if we're doing a Fourier transform on this, that the first coefficient is dc and so on, and that's the last, that we see a mirror because the signal is real. So let's start octave here and let's start type our sequence in there, 2, 9, 3, and 6. So it's nicely arranged there. So now let's create the Fourier transform of this. That's done with the command FFT. So let's do that. Let's do an XF, and I do this with a colon, and we see this nicely vertical. Okay, so now we've got these readings here. So the first coefficient is 32, and then we've got here 0, a 5, 12, and then again a 5, and then here a 0 again. So and therefore, so we see already here that this 0 corresponds to this 0 here and the 5 to this one here. So let's just write this down here on our sheet of paper. And maybe I can move this terminal on the side here and we can still see that. And so the XF of 1. So this is hopefully our DC. Let's move this here a bit further out that we see that, like this. And then we've got our XF of 2 here, and then our XF of 3 and our XF of 4 here. So now we see that the XF of 2 is identical to the XF of 6, and then this is identical to XF of 5 here. Not identical, but that looks like the complex conjugate. So why is that the case here, that we have this here? This is because X is real or real valued. Yeah, so remember this, what we've proven a couple of lectures before or sections before, that if X is real valued, we are getting basically the mirrored version here. So XF of 4 is alone, and this corresponds to the highest frequency here. So far so good. So we have now seen this works. Let's just quickly check the DC coefficient here. So we've got the value of 32 out here. So that's our value of 32, what we are getting here out there. And so we see this is probably just the sum of these numbers here. So essentially what this means here is this is the sum of X. So if we want to have the actual DC value of this, we need to divide this by N.